It's the 100th meeting between the Bengals and the Steelers, and it comes in primetime Monday night. Marisa Contipelli checking in from Pittsburgh, joined by ESPN analyst Booger McFarland. Now, Booger, putting the records aside in this one, you have two rivals going head-to-head in week four. Now, history has been on Pittsburgh's side as of late, but what would a win for Cincinnati do, given that the AFC North is currently wide open?
Well, I think it'd be huge, not only for Cincinnati, but for Pittsburgh also. I think it's still early in the season. I think everyone needs to remember that the season isn't over. But anytime you get rivals together, you know the old cliche, you can throw the records out. There's a lot of built-in anger for each other. You want to go out and you want to be physical. I think this is going to be a really, really physical, hard-hitting game tomorrow.
Now, when you look at the Steelers' offense, it's a little different than what it has been in previous years. Most notably, quarterback Ben Roethlisberger will not be suiting up since he's out with an injury. Mason Rudolph now taking the lead. What does he do well, and what is his abilities? How do they come in a positive light when you're talking about a Bengals defense who has struggled at times during the season?
Well, when you talk about Mason, he's a quarterback that has a big arm. He can make all the throws, and I think he's getting more comfortable. You can tell when he got thrown in against Seattle, he wasn't quite comfortable. Making his first start last week on the road, now he comes home. Now he gets more comfortable, and he wants to throw the football down the field. And so I think for Cincinnati, rushing the passer, look for Sam, Geno, Carlos, those guys are going to have a big day because Mason is going to want to push the ball down the field.
On the flip side, the Bengals were able to run the ball better against Buffalo in the second half last week. What will this offense need to do to create sustaining and positive drives?
Well, I think they have to get first downs. You know, when we talked to Coach, one of the things he mentioned was we got to get in rhythm. And how do you get in rhythm? You got to call more plays. You got to get first downs. You got to run the football. I think Joe Mixon is one of the best running backs in this league. He's a three-down back. He's big. He's fast. He's physical. He can catch the football. This offense is built around running the football, tempo, a little bit of no huddle. You got to have the ball to do all that. So they need to get first downs, and I think a big onus is going to be put on the offensive line to make sure that they can sustain drives and move the football down the field.
Both teams enter Monday night looking for that first win of the season. What is a matchup that you're going to be watching closely?
Well, I think it's going to be the Steeler offensive line against the Cincinnati defensive line. I think that's the strength of this team. You know, you look at Geno and Carlos and Sam and everything that they do up front against a Steeler offensive line that, quite frankly, I don't think they're playing very well. So if Cincinnati's going to win this game, they're going to have to dominate that matchup, their D-line against the Steeler offensive line.
Well, Booger, thank you so much for your time and insight. Cincinnati and Pittsburgh will kick off at 8:15 Monday night, and you can catch all the action on ESPN.